Member of the Oversight Committee and author of this brand new book, bestseller, Unified. He wrote it with Senator Tim Scott. Congressman, got to have you respond directly to that. Do you think it was necessary for him to tell the president in the step back that it was financed by your opponents, by Hillary Clinton?
It's certainly a relevant fact. Whether or not he should have told the president, the FBI certainly should have told the FISA court. That's my bigger concern, is they didn't tell the folks who authorized the warrant. It's a really relevant fact. It helps you understand the motivation behind that salacious material or allegations. But for sure, they should have told the court. I think it would have been nice to tell the person who was the subject of the dossier also.
Well, he had conversations with the president. So if the president found out about this dossier, don't you think his question to Comey was probably, where did you get this information? He would, I'm almost certain he asked him that. And so for Comey to say, I never told him it was financed by Hillary Clinton, what does that say about him?
Well, of course, you would want to know where you got the information, because that determines how reliable it is and whether or not it can be used. So we already know the FBI did not vet or investigate the allegations in the dossier. So if I were the president, I'd want to know, where'd you get it, and how have you vetted it before you used it?
Sure. Well, apparently, when they were talking about the dossier at that Trump Tower meeting during the transition, Congressman, it does sound, according to the book, that at one point, Mr. Trump was told by Mr. Comey, we are not investigating you. So that lines up with what the president has said in the past. And also, he goes on to say that apparently it does not, whatever President Trump told Mr. Comey, it does not rise to the level of obstruction of justice. He did nothing wrong. Ultimately, doesn't that help the president's case?
These Comey memos are defense exhibit A in an obstruction of justice. I've read them. Very few members of Congress have, and no one outside of Congress has read the Comey memos. I think they ought to be released. I think they ought to be released publicly, but they certainly ought to be released to Congress. They would be defense exhibit A in an obstruction of justice prosecution.
Is there any reason they should not be revealed? I mean, are there national secrets in there, grand jury testimony, any of that stuff the DOJ always says?
I hope not. Comey gave them to a law professor, so I hope not.
What about the idea of a former FBI director writing a book? What was the process? What is the process? Would he have had to, would the DOJ have to read the book before to make sure he wasn't releasing classified information? And what do you think about an FBI director writing a book?
I think it's sad. I think it's sad. One of the things Director Comey and I did agree on is we need an apolitical FBI. We had some fairly heated exchanges about that. I can't think of anyone who's done a better job of politicizing the FBI than he has in the last 36 to 48 hours by talking about tanning bed goggles and the length of a tie. That is beneath the dignity of the offices that he held. So I'm really disappointed whether or not the intelligence community's vetted this book. I hope he let them do it so he's not disseminating classified information. My guess is he did. But the writing of the book in general, and then some of the things that he's talking about, are just frankly beneath the dignity of some really important offices he once held.
Talked about how much stronger he was. The president wasn't as tall as he thought. He tried to bring him in. You got to be a stronger guy to bring me in than the president is. Real quick, came out with his press conference October 28th and said that we found these additional emails on Anthony Weiner's laptop. He did it because he was under the assumption that she was going to win. And she didn't want her to start her presidency under the guise of a scandal or
illegitimate.
What's your reaction to that?
Well, there were a lot of things that could have called into question the legitimacy of that investigation, including what he's now made reference to that some of us have alluded to a lot in the past, which is the real reason he had the July 5th press conference. It wasn't the tarmac. It was information he had about Loretta Lynch that if it became public, people would question their objectivity.
Right.
Look, I defended him in 2016. This is Hillary Clinton's fault that he found himself in that position. And it was Democrats that wanted to put him in jail this time last year. It wasn't Republicans. He had a tough 2016, but he's making it worse by writing this kind of a tabloid book.
Congressman, what about Pompeo? Will he be confirmed?
I hope so. You know, Ansley, it got 13 Democrat votes a year ago. I mean, go back and look at how many Republicans opposed John Kerry and Hillary Clinton. Almost none. So for a group that likes to talk about bipartisanship and reaching across the aisle, you have a uniquely well-qualified Secretary of State candidate, and you can't find a single Democrat on the committee to support him?
Yeah, you think same-sex marriage should have been a question? That's what Senator Cory Booker wanted to know.
No, I doubt they asked that of Clinton or Kerry, and I guarantee they didn't ask, can you be independent from the person who's giving you the job? It's a double standard. Thank goodness Mike Pompeo is uniquely well qualified, and I hope some Democrats not on the committee will insist that he be brought to the floor.
Well, there are a number of Democrats who live in states that Donald Trump won big that if they don't vote that way, they're going to be in hot water come November. Trey Gowdy, Congressman from the great state of South Carolina. We know it's really noisy there in the Capitol. Thank you very much
for
talking to us today.
Joe Montana-like concentration, despite.